Hello, this is Mr. Cox, Podcast 21. I want to talk a little bit more about some of the Halloween stuff that I was thinking about. I was talking about the walnut thing we used to do. And I used to go hunting walnuts and mushrooms. Now, you gotta know what you're doing. You're mushrooms. You can do different things. But we go hunting mushrooms with my grandpa. Go hunting nuts with my uncle and aunt. One time, my uncle and aunt, they were getting older, had some health problems. She's like going down this slope. Like there's a good way down in this wood area, and she gets her feet tangled up in like some weed roots and things, and she's like calling my uncle for help. He came over to help her, and he just grabbed the roots and yanked them out from her foot, and she just slid on down. So it kind of helped her, kind of didn't, but you know, they joked about it forever after she did it. Was a little ticked off at the moment first, but it's just kind of interesting sometimes. Then we devised this thing that I wouldn't recommend this either, but where you jack up the back of your vehicle and had this trough that you put the walnuts in to shell them because it took forever to shell them. And that was this game of focus thing we did and pick them in the week. Pick the nuts out. We don't have these times for picking nuts after they dry. Pick the nuts out of the good part out of the shell. And then when mom would use it to make candy and cookies or to get stuff, but put these in a thing that you put your like your truck tire down, you lure it in, and you feed the hole, and it says throwing them out. It makes a big mess. I know some people, one of my friends' stepdads actually used to make stain on the walnuts. You could make your own stain instead of buying it, but be careful with it against it. But you know, we get a big slop of mess on this if you get behind the tire, you just throw that stuff out. So some other stuff that I was thinking for about Halloween. When my sister, brother, and I, we used to go to my aunt Nicole's. They had a dog named Lady, a German Shepherd dog. And she was like, she would bark and carry on like with a mad bark. Maybe I came in the door. But it didn't matter how we dressed. My aunt Nicole always knew it was us, because Lady knew us regardless of how we were dressed. And she would, you know, she'd start barking, the door rang, we'd come in, then she'd be all excited to see us, and wagging her tail, come to greet us and stuff. So they're like, oh, it's my niece's nephew. My niece and nephew's. So like, yeah, so that was cool. But the dog always gave us away, but that was a really nice thing. They had, I don't know if I mentioned this in here, I'll mention it here, right? I can't remember where I would have mentioned it. Been in the video, but they would always get rescue dogs. So instead of going and spending a lot of money to get a dog with papers, they would go get them from a pound or a rescue place. So they was on their sleep and at home. They had, after Lady passed away, they adopted another dog named Rebel. It was a red Irish setter. He's red, they're orange. So it's not good for dogs to eat chocolate, but they came home one day, and my aunt had made like this whole big thing of chocolate cupcakes. This dog had been literally starved by its humans. What's wrong with people? If they can't feed the animal, they need to get help from an animal group or something. They'll just starve the poor animal. So it was like skin and bones and out of the middle. So it was none of these. It would eat everything in sight, and they had to watch it. Didn't put too much weight on it. Probably because the cupcakes were chocolate, but not strong chocolate like you find like in chocolate candy and things. It didn't hurt it, but you know, can get too much chocolate. I think cats do, you know, feed them chocolate. So they came home, all of it's gone. Cupcakes gone. There's nobody else in the house. I forget what it was, 20-some cupcakes. And the dog's just sitting there smiling. Of course, you know, eventually it threw up cupcakes. So I had some friends. I used to go to their house and stuff all the time. So they had a golden retriever, that, and they also had a black cat. And they made, one time as well, these were real chocolate things. This could have really killed the dog. But thankfully they didn't. They were, each one was like a collar, like a slab of chocolate, and made it in a kind of cookie shape. But they had nuts in them and stuff, and they could chocolate. And she had them all wrapped aluminum foil, and then she had snakes and stuff in this thing with, like, what do you call that stuff? That see-through wrap. They used to call it something else. It was that cling wrap that you wear around them. So I'm over there watching the house jams or something. I didn't walk by one time. And I watched in the cat. It was literally taking its, they call it a fang, the cookies, and sticking them through its canine teeth. I should say the femur teeth for cat. Sticking them through the cellophane, plastic wrap, saran wrap, those are two again. Sampling the cookies. And so I like put them up so she went those cookies. I looked which ones had been fanged, took them out, put for saran wrap around, and I told her, you know, she got home. That's what your cat was doing. They all thought it was funny, you know, but was glad that I removed it so they didn't serve gas fanged cookies. But their dog got into the chocolate and nut things and ate them, a bunch of them, maybe all of them. And you know, of course they come on board where to go. You know, it's just looking like dogs do. Like, I don't have anything to do with it. Well, next day or two, he used the restroom and big balls of aluminum with some chocolate left in it came out. Thankfully it came out. It could have killed him. It could have impacted in there. He could have got too much caffeine and died, but thankfully not. But that dog was a wonderful dog. Shadrack was his name. He liked oatmeal cream pies. And I would get to let the light oatmeal cream pies. I always had it with me for teenagers. It was like eating and stuff. And I liked eating. I was kept in my trunk. And then I had a Jeep Cherokee. And he come running to see me one time. He's so happy. He wanted to get his oatmeal cream pie. He liked to get a sleep. He liked to see him anyway. And most of the time he was in the backyard. He was out front exercising every day. So he come over. He ran. I put the window down. So I said, hush, I'm running. Claws just scratch all down his side. And my vehicle, you know, I wasn't real super happy about it, but I like the dog too much. I'm like, yeah, don't do anything to it. It's not his fault. He was just happy to see me. I gave him a great time. But, again, you know, I just give him one now and then. He wouldn't want to feed him much of those either. So, what else was I going to say about him? He was a great dog, but he was afraid of the outside at night. So they had to keep him, like, in the garage and keep the door propped open where he could get to the garage because he had to go outside to use the bathroom at night. He'd be terrified. He'd have to turn the porch light off for him because if he'd see a shadow or something, it was scary. Later, they got, so he was having some health problems that they couldn't really treat very well. Not serious, but a lot of skin problems, different kinds of things, allergies. And then none of them were able to take care of him very well, so they found some wealthy people in Indianapolis that adopted him. They could get him his medical treatment better and spend more time with him. So, a wonderful dog. Halloween stories. One time we had this, for my little brother, we had this Halloween party for him. And I was Icy Fingers. I died in this one room and had a glove that was filled with ice. Kids loved it, you know, the little kids that were on the door and they're like, Icy Fingers! And they're like, ah! And then you want to touch the icy hand. And it was just ice in the glove. They were all freaked out. But we had it so decorated. It had those, like, those recordings of ghostly sounds and everything. It had all the skills and things hanging and all kinds of things. We had a little fun house. It was really fun. Except that night, everybody kind of got the creeps in the house. And we, like, had to take it all down. That anymore. I don't know what that was about, but it was creepy. It was fun during the day, but there was some like creepy feeling about it at night. So there seems like there was something else I was going to say about the trick or treat. Oh, I know what it was. So with the youth group, I had some kids that wanted to go trick or treating with them. Mid sized town. A lot of people get trick or treating or something, and I don't know what it was because I'm, you know, an adult. And then, yeah, I came trick or treating with this. So I dressed up, and we went trick or treating. Dressed up, I think, like a gothic musician or something. We're going down through, like, this place to place. We met this little girl. She's, like, walking with us. I don't know. This place is a home, looks like a barn. She's like, yeah, witch, and I live there, blah, blah, blah. So she walked with us for a while. We went to this one house, and we get to the door. Most people were, like, laughing. You know, because it was an adult. You know, this one place is old. It's like, you know, there is an age limit to this. I didn't know there was, but usually I didn't do that. I was just having fun. Supervise them so they stay safe, but that was the last day of that. So, unless I think I get some more trick or treat. reading things that I can't right now.